We were doing pretty much our idle speed, which is about 6 knots, going up this channel, and all of a sudden, the biggest, most terrifying sound that I heard was a big and a and the boat shuddered. Basically, what had happened is that there was a big boulder, and you know, our stabilizers are basically wings underneath the water that stick out. And as the boat rolls, they turn in different directions. They reduce roll by about 90%, and they reduce pitch by about 60%.
This is Captain G Wiz with your G Wiz information of the day. Stabilizers are a pair of wings or fins on the bottom of the boat that counteract the movement of the boat going through the water. They prevent rolling or pitching in the vessel and provides a much more comfortable voyage. Now let's take a look at the meaning of rolling and pitching. A pitch is the vertical movement of the bow up and down. A roll is side to side, both equally as uncomfortable. Here's an example of our stabilizers at work. It may not look like much at first, but with 10-foot waves hitting us at our side, even the most experienced sailors might start to feel a little queasy. Seasickness on a long trip like this could prove catastrophic. Always make sure your stabilizer and its settings are running correctly, or you might start looking a little green in the face.
Captain G Wiz out.
When it hit the stabilizer and the stabilizer shattered, it ricocheted the rock right into our right propeller. We hired a diver to go down, and the picture you're looking at right now, it's kind of hard to see, but basically it's, if you see the cutaway of the stabilizer, it's white foam, and basically a large suitcase portion of the stabilizer was literally ripped away. And that's kind of hard to see the propellers, but if you look really close as the diver's down there, you'll see how the propellers bent, the tips are bent back. And that's the damage that we did to the vessel. So they didn't have any ability right there to fix the propellers, and we had to get on our way. So we continued up to Charleston, where we were planning on spending about a month there. And we hired a diver and their diving crew, and they went down, and so what you're seeing pictures right now is the diving crew heading down, and what they use is the props themselves. I want to say weighed, I don't remember, but I want to say it was around 200 or 300 pounds each prop weighs. And so they use these inflatable bags as they get the propeller off the bottom of the boat. And then that inflatable bag, they basically pulled it up on the side, and that's what you're seeing them pull up on the side, which is the propeller. And if you look really close on the edges of the propeller, you can see where they were bent back. So we took the propellers, we sent them out to a shop and had them refinished. Basically, they can bend them back into shape with heat, and then they refinish the surface. So here you see the propellers completely refinished before they were put on. As you can see, it's a really shiny finish, and the edges have all been corrected. The stabilizer, on the other hand, that took a little longer to fix, because first of all, we had to have a stabilizer actually made, and it took, I want to say it was about 2 or 3 months for the stabilizer to be built and then shipped here to the U.S. And then you're talking about something that weighs about 450 to 500 pounds. So that's challenging in itself. And where we were up in the Clearwater area, there was no availability for us to actually haul the boat out of the water.
This is Captain G-Wiz with your second dose of information for the day.
No matter what size boat you own, you'll have to get a haul out at some point. Haul outs are extremely important for the health of the vessel. Haul outs allow you to address a variety of problems, including bottom paint, hull paint, or any other maintenance you might need to do on the bottom of the boat. If you plan on hauling out your boat, make sure the marina you go to has a lift big enough for your boat. Make sure you always listen to the crew on the docks helping you out, because of course you don't want to add to the task list of things to prepare. Keep in mind, the crew on the dock do this every day. You might do this once every 2 years. Make sure you regularly take care of haulouts and any other routine maintenance, or else the cost might start adding up.
Captain G-Wiz out.
Which means take it out of the, there was no facilities around that could accommodate a boat our size. So we wanted to get the stabilizer fixed. So we hired a marine commercial dive crew that works on cruise ships and oil tankers. And they came up with this rig that was pretty interesting, whereby it was basically encasing the stabilizer, and it had floats on either side, so you could actually drop this into the water. And so that's what you're seeing here is basically we're hooking up the stabilizer, and they're getting ready to haul it out of the water. If you kind of look in the background, it's kind of interesting. We had the U.S. Coast Guard standing by too, is because we had to make sure that all of the vessel traffic that was coming by was going really, really slow. Because any movement to the vessel, as you had the stabilizer underneath the boat, could really endanger people's lives, because you've got this very heavy, large thing, this large stabilizer hanging off. So anyhow, you see the pictures now with the stabilizer fully attached to the boat, finally. So that was our one and only really large damage to the vessel. This is the kind of stuff that happens, and it doesn't matter, who you have at the helm and how careful you are. The reality is the undersea environment is changing all of the time, and you just never know when you're gonna hit something or run into something. We know more about the moon than we do about our undersea floor, if that puts anything in perspective. No kidding.
On the next episode, we'll be preparing to head back south for the winter. We'll be going through everything that we do to prepare for a long voyage.
If you enjoyed this video and want to see the channel grow, please leave a like, comment, share with your friends, and subscribe.
And if you haven't seen it already, click the link for our previous video. See you next time.